standing here. And maybe do some more details on the dragon and do the cliffs and things. Okay, let's see. I just rebooted my computer, so hopefully my stream should be nice and sharp. Yesterday I had to stop and redo it because it was getting kind of clunky, but I just restarted everything, so it should be. We'll see. Most of this should be dry, but some of that white is still a little tacky. Just gotta scale my figure here. Did a study of this figure today, just in my sketchbook. Very generic, kind of grayish color, sort of an under structure here just to find the silhouette. This is always tricky. The tinier the figure is, the trickier it gets. Those legs could be a little longer. Could be longer. And this arm could be a little longer too. Yeah, it needs to be longer legs. That's all right. Maybe to about there. Let's get a blue brush going on here for this water. Basically having to reshape the cliff to match my figure. She's a little taller than I had first thought. Hey there, Brandon. How's it going? Thank you. Again, the old pewter before it dies on me. I want this even taller. Yeah, she needs to have longer legs. Oh, I'm really chiseling away this cliff here. And cliff there. I want her right on the tip. Very, very edge. Okay, that's a little better. Nice long legs. Here's the back of the ankle, and here's the top of this foot. You like how the paintings evolve? Yeah, it's a cool process. I mean, even for me, it's harder for me to recognize sometimes because I'm doing it. That's why I'm constantly standing up and stepping back, so I can see what it looks like. Oops. I just been wearing kind of a greenish, bluish, light white sort of fabric dress thing. I know it looks like a man right now, I just haven't done the right variations to it. To make it look like a whoa man. Still hoping this is tall enough. Myself. I guess I could make that still a little taller. Yeah. Really nice long legs. little longer of a foot. Heels a little too low. Ooh, this is just really tough business with such a tiny little figure. Space Cow, thank you. How's it going? Okay, now that I got my figure a little more figured out, this could be leaning forward a little bit more, I think. These little subtle differences in the gesture really make a difference. Could be just a little bigger. slowly turning into a nice figure. In awe at your skills. Thank you very much. Well, I've been doing this my entire life, and I'm constantly studying and working to improve. So it's a lot of hard work, but I absolutely enjoy it. This leg is actually bent a little more. I did have a model pose for this, my girlfriend. As an artist, your most convenient model is yourself. Your second most convenient model is your significant other. I use Amber a lot. She's also very lovely, so that certainly helps. It's just like when I do a figure with as a very visible face, I'll spend easily as much time on just the face as I will on the rest of the entire painting. This is kind of the same thing. Really, really tiny little figure, but really important to nail that. So I could easily spend as much time on this little figure as I did in this entire dragon. Which, you know, still, I spent a good amount of time on that thing. And then the landscapey stuff is easy, it just flings together. I think the landscapey stuff is when I can be more loose and gestural, more brushy. But the figure, tight anatomy things, I feel like I need to be more specific with. And I did this sketch this morning. Came out pretty good, a good study. This was the figure that it's gonna be. I did this in just pen and ink this morning. So, flowy stuff for light to go through. So that's what I'm kind of looking at. Also, even my photo isn't this accurate. Trying to put this somewhere where I could see it. Find a clip or something. Hang on. My big fat schnoz in the way here. Just trying to put this, there we go, in a place I could see it. Get some nice green going on here. It's gonna come off. Wind. That's what I want. Right up to her calf, I think. Her hips there. Bit here. Nice bright green glow there. Let's see, I need a dark green for the shadow. This whole dress is a little more green than that. Whole dress is in shadow for the most part. Start with a general local tone color, and there's the plane change. Nice flowy robey outfit or whatever she's wearing. Some really great. I love these moments for some really hot color.
Hot.
And then it's something in between. Give me some green. There we go. Kind of like how I can still see a little bit of the flesh tone through the dress. It's kind of fun. Makes it look kind of like sheer. Okay, let's do, move around the figure a little bit. Let's do that highlight on top of that foot. Let's push that ankle a little bit. And I can do some really nice skin glowy parts too here. Like underneath here. Here. She's gonna have kind of a shawl thing on too. In fact, let's do that now. It's kind of a pinkish, which means in the shadow it might be a little more green. That's coming along slowly. Think I want to do a bit of a pink one. Pink flowy back there. That would be. Let's try that. Just a couple brush strokes is all it takes, folks. Even though this is still really detailed, you can still be brushy and gestural. It's like you use the same techniques. You just use a smaller brush. Let's get some nice bright green ones in there now. And I feel like just because of the color of the light, I do need some yellow. Even here. I'm using oils. I did an acrylic underpainting though. So I do use acrylic for certain things. The underpainting, I like that stage doing acrylic because I can do many, many layers of color and texture within a few minutes. So I have been doing that for the last couple of years, I think. See, now I can go through and blend some of these things. Because it's still wet. That's the beauty of oil. It's wet for at least the rest of the day. Maybe tacky the next day. Sure, Brandon. Glad you guys are watching and enjoying it. Yeah, please follow the video channel here if you want to see more of these. I do this once a week. At least. I've been doing this dragon series for the last, this is my third painting I've done of this. Not the right color at all. I need more. What? A little more pink. It's a little too green. Little under shadow underneath the chin, maybe a little more pink on this shoulder. Yeah, we might be able to see a bit of rim light. This calf, front of the leg, I mean, and maybe for sure this shoulder here. I love the fabric just glowing, just sort of that midair sort of capture of that movement adds a lot of movement to this piece. It's funny, it looks so detailed until you get up close, you're like, wow, there's nothing there. That's the game, I think. I think that's fun. All right, let's do some nice dark blue. Green, purple, something. like underneath here. Showing a line, a plane underneath the boobs. It's always helpful, and a couple little shadows of fabric. And let's do the opposite. Let's do a lit plane. Where the plane changes there. That might be a little more forward, too far back. Push that forward a little bit. Yeah, I'll have to do her hand. Her front hand is going to be a little. I'm gonna get my little tiny brushes out for that. My really little tiny brushes. Alright, her hair. I think she's gonna have dark hair. Let's say like a dark brown. What was this, my watercolor? Okay, I don't need this anymore. Good. Start with some poiple. I love Williamsburg paint. They have so much rich, transparent dark. It's great. I can just mix all these together and get all kinds of fun darks. I don't have black on my palette. I've used black before. It's a great color. Now this will really make this read great. A little more medium. And then let's do a little more. Let's do some orange down here. Brown hair definitely becomes orange in the right light. she should be a little more red because we're getting some light diffraction here. That's going to be really important. Oh, there's a bunch of comments. Thanks, guys. I didn't look over. We actually have prints of this piece available. Nick, I don't know if you're watching. If you want to post those. If not, I can do that real quick. I keep forgetting to do that. And we actually have a 40% off sale going on right now. Check that out. And also, here's our Patreon. If you guys like my work and want to follow us and support us on Patreon, I also have a lot of my painting courses on there as part of a membership. So if you want to study painting with me, I have those courses available. So check those two out. If you want to buy a print of this piece, you can pre-order it before I'm even finished. And they're 40% off right now, all the stuff on there. So check that out. There's a nice glowy glow hair stuff going on. Here on the top of the hair. Hand down here. This hand isn't really doing much. I is angled down now. So we're going to see that lower plane and a little shadow in there. Against the fabric. Yeah, if anything, this dragon series I've been doing has been teaching me to slow down a bit and spend more time in these little tiny details. I love being gestural and brushy, but sometimes this is a kind of cool to take your time on it and do it like this. She looks phenomenal. Oh, good. She's almost done. Well, you can buy prints. We have them as little as 40 bucks for a paper print, and they're 40% off, so it's like 26 bucks. So for $26, you can buy a print of this piece if you like it, which, you know, I'm glad you do. So, yeah. We do try to make artwork affordable. That's kind of one of my philosophies, is to have affordable artwork that regular people can buy. Yeah, check out the link that I posted there. We have canvas and paper and all different kinds of ones, different sizes and stuff. All right, let me get my little teeny brushes out. Actually, let me stand up. It's been about an hour or so. So I just take a stretch. Ugh. I have a mirror back here too. Sometimes I just need to look in the mirror at the painting, not myself. Look in the mirror and go, "Hey, looking good." No, I'm looking at the painting. Because it reverses it and just makes it, you can kind of notice things that you hadn't noticed. Yeah, I love how this is coming out. I'm going to leave a little, very little detail in her face. I like that it's very anonymous. And plus it's kind of silhouetted. I like that aspect of it. Got some little guys. This is as small as I get. These are some little tiny brushes. Just to iron out her face a little bit. Little tiny bit of a nose. That's too dark. Let's lighten that up just a little bit. Hey, there's a gnat on my painting. Go away. Unless you're going to become a permanent resident. Here we go. I don't know what to do with the face. I like that it's faceless and kind of anonymous. It's kind of cool. Let me put a little bit of highlighted plane up. Brush down. Shit. Hate it when I do that. Drop it right in my paint. Big old blob of something on there. Where did that go? Okay, jeez. Hey Matt, how's it going? Yeah, you might not see the face because of the silhouette action. And I do like, whenever I can, leaving a painting more anonymous so that you can put yourself, anyone could be this person, you know. Right hand. Down a little bit. I'm doing good, Matt. Just working on this really fun and challenging piece. I say every time I do this, I'm challenging myself and pushing. Let's push that wrist up just a little. Little moment there, you know. This painting is called Disarming. Because I think it's important to find the reasons to put down your weapons instead of picking them up. That's looking good. Let's see. Yeah, let's do a little more green glowy action here. Sort of show the shape of her leg a little better there. Yeah, I like that. I like that it's brushy when you get up close, but from far away it looks more detailed than it is. That's a little trick. Glow on this guy up here. All right, that works. Maybe it wants a tour. I can do this real quick. That's a little straight on shot. So you can see, look how brushy that is. There's no detail there, but it totally looks like there is. Let me change this to autofocus real quick. Focus auto, good. I think that this is as close as it gets. And then here the dragons. I might do a little bit of a plane change on his, maybe his eyelid or something, because it's like a dark hole. I showed the socket, but I haven't put anything in it yet. Yeah, just a lid might be all I need. So, yeah, that came out really good. That was only about an hour and a half, maybe. Pretty good. And here's my model. That's my girlfriend Amber in our living room, with a light behind her that I have and the lamp. Nothing fabulous. Yeah, she's my most convenient model, and she's lovely, so it works great. And then there's the sketch that I did this morning as a study, just to figure the pose out and stuff and the light and everything. I did that at the coffee shop on the patio. It's a great way to start a Saturday, right? So, and that became that. So, pretty cool. Yeah, it worked out great. Yeah, no detail on the face, but you don't need it. You know, like it makes it kind of anonymous. So, so now I gotta detail out the cliffs, and I gotta eventually add some scales on the dragon. That's always pretty tedious work, actually. Now, if I can put this back on without dropping it. There we go. Hi there, Lori. Thank you. Yeah, let me just do a little plane on top of this eyelid. I think that's all I need for the dragon. Not too light. And then what to do with the cliffs back here. I've got some ideas. Yeah, just a little indication of some eyelids there. And maybe that doesn't need to be so dark. I think I'll let this dry again and do some glowy stuff around her and around. Yeah, that'll be the next phase after this is dry, which will just be like, you know, tomorrow or whatever. Okay, figure done. That was challenging. Figured it out though. Yes. Now, these cliffs. Put my book away. It's funny, this whole idea came from a sketch that I found in an old sketchbook. This is like a couple years old, maybe from last year or something. I was going through a sketchbook and I found this old sketch that I did like on a plane to go into a show or something, just in pencil. I think I just did it randomly, just off the top of my head, and forgot about it and found it the other day. I'm like, oh, this is a cool idea. Why don't I do that? Now that I'm painting dragons, this will be fun. So I busted it out and turned into that. So yeah, save all your old sketches. They are valuable, not for money, but for your own record of your own ideas. Got some ideas for these cliffs. I want them fairly rocky, I think. In this case, kind of a purple. Really, really subtle. Darker. Little darker. A little more gray. Very thin. A little more gray. And then a little lighter. Did a lot of medium on this. These long vertical cliffs. And it gets more obscure as it gets toward the bottom. Let's get a lighter color. I want to imply that these are, I need to show the perspective a little better. Here's the horizon. Okay, this can get a little lighter as it's getting a little higher. That's too light.
course, this isn't the most exciting part, but it's really, really important. This subtle environment stuff. This makes the whole painting grounded in some kind of a reality. Nothing real detailed or complicated. Let's look and see what that looks like.
That looks great. I even thought about maybe indicating some water around the bottom, as if we can see where it hits the water, just for fun. Same thing on this side. Changing hands because I get a better angle with the brush. I want the front of the brush. Pointing toward the light here makes my shadow softer. And I use the texture of the surface to help. Voila, rocks. 2 second rocks. Let's do down here now. Make this a little darker again. More medium. Yeah, this could be a bunch of fun little bits of rock. That's be a little lighter. Maybe this is a whole plane that's facing upward. Yeah, we'll put some indications of some water down here. As if we can barely see the bottom of this little ravine. Couple more little shinies. That was way too much purple. That happens all the time. It's all right. Maybe we'll do a little more red pink inside here. A little lighter. Way more thin. A little more blue. Yeah, using the texture of my surface, which I build these wood panels myself, so I can do whatever I want with the surface. It's pretty great. Instant rocks. Ba-ding. These long, weird, vertical rocks. It's kind of fun. These could be a little lighter, maybe a little more green even. Perfect. Oh, that looks so good. And it's so simple. If you can imply the detail, not instead of painting every rock, I think it looks so much more natural. Just a couple little brush strokes. I could soften this up a bit. Once again, oil paint. You can push it around for a while. If you're gonna do, you can use acrylic also to help, but you should do that. You need to do that first, because oil and water don't mix. You need to put acrylic down first, do whatever you want, let it dry, and then do oil. That is the only order you can do it in, or your painting will fall apart in a couple years. And you'll be like, sad face. Well, that's looking so good. Okay, cliffs that they're standing on. I might want to use a bigger brush for this. Let me stand up and just take a break. Gotta stand up and stretch. Incidentally, if you like my painting stuff here, please follow us on whatever video channel you're watching. You can watch more of these. I do this a couple times a week. We have prints available. And incidentally, the original is available as well. I guess I can post that here. And we have a 40% off prints. Well, I think actually everything. Ba-doom, there's the link for that. And if you like our gallery and you want to support us, and you get some cool members only stuff, we have a Patreon, which I just put there. I'm sorry, I'm just adjusting my cord here. So it doesn't get in the way. It's dangling down. All right, let me look in the mirror. Look in the mirror and check out how I'm doing. How you doing there, self? Yeah, I think some glowy glow after this dries will make it really come together. As if it's not coming together already, but you know, it'll really sing. You ever been to Cinque Terre? That's where I got the reference for these rocks that I'm using. This is actually a lot easier to take off now that I turned it over. I went to Cinque Terre. I've been there several times, but look at those cliffs. How they're like kind of angled, that chiseled look to them. That's kind of what I'm using sort of for my idea here. So, you know, you get ideas from everywhere. This is the hazard of taking that thing off of the... So I can't get it back in again. There we go. Sorry about the motion sick a bit there. These cliffs are kind of red up close, so let's do some purpley color. Gonna need some more medium first. Playing with this idea of using this cobalt dryer in my medium to make my paint dry a little faster, but it's a little fumy. It's like subtle, but it's like, is this killing me slowly? And I don't realize it, I don't know. Just two drops in this bit of medium. You can't put it in your paint directly. It'll apparently dry it so fast that it cracks. I need a lot of this stuff. Whatever color I'm about to make. Bust out the old palette knife. This is why you use a glass palette. That's not bad. Let's try that. Actually gonna try this tool that I made. I make a lot of my own tools because they're awesome. I can do whatever I want. That looks much better. It's quickly getting too light though. I need to make it darker. Yeah, this stuff is just a little fumey. I can sense it. I try to be good with... Let's make a lip. Like she's standing on the edge there. Ooh, that's nice. That came out really good. Little bit of a lip there. Let's make a slightly darker version of this stuff. Looks great. Texture for the win. Look at that. Instarock. Thanks, Instarock. And, alright, let's do that over here. I'm going to do a little bit of more, a lighter one there. Ooh, I gotta nail out his claws. I have not done that yet. Let the paint and the texture do the work for you. There's no way I could paint something that pretty by hand. Like every little crevice and every little detail. You gotta let the paint do the work. Save that. Darker here. Light there through the gap. That looks amazing. This might be over quicker than I thought. Let's do a lighter. Oh, I still got to do some scales and the hands. Yeah, that's going to be at least another hour or so. Two sets of dragon clawsy claws. Let's do a little bit of this. This is supposed to be kind of a... Yeah, greenish, bluish, orange. If that makes any sense. Not red. Maybe
whisper of some green. Let's try that. And I can still see some of the red from underneath. That's fun. Love transparent layers of color. You can do so many fun things with that. So the paint I put on yesterday is already dry because of my new fangled medium. John, are you watching this right now? Oh, what a goofball. Let's get a little lighter. Oh, hey, that cobalt stuff is just a little bit of fuminess. I don't know if I like that. Makes me nervous more than anything. Let's do a little bit of light. Push that around a little bit. That looks cool. Let's put a little bit of that here to define this edge a little better. Oh, that looks so good. Yeah, these paintings are really a challenge, and I'm developing so many more great ideas and techniques because of them. Okay, dragon hands. Realize something about the hands. Might even take a picture of my own hand. Sometimes I do that because that kind of stuff is really valuable. Yeah, because it needs to hit something. Especially be like that. Alright,
I'm gonna take a picture of my own hand real quick as a reference. Don't mind me. I'm a professional. That will be helpful. I've decided that it's totally okay to need a reference. It'll help you get what you're getting. It'll help you figure out something. Totally fine. It is good to be able to imagine this stuff, but if you need a reference for something, totally fine. Okay, wow, this stuff dries really fast. It's already drying on my palette here. Let's do that a little more pink, because this is kind of in shadow. Where it hits, boom, something there, and here's a claw, and then we'll just do three. Let's say this is the darker. Too saturated. It's going to be claws clinging here. I doing? Could use another muscle right here. Oops. Nice rotating pronation there. Cool, that looks great. Okay, back legs. Hi there, Camilla. Thank you. Yeah, I did the figure today, the cliffs, and I'm gonna do some more detail on the dragon. I'm doing some feats right now. Some lower feet that he's standing on, or that they. Dragon doesn't really, don't know the gender. Tail. I don't think I need to cover the whole thing with scales, just some highlights, highlighted areas. That's what I think about here. And a little more of this. great. Let's take a picture of this. Incidentally, on my Patreon, I've got all these photos available, these progress photos that I take. So you can look and study the progress of a whole painting. I'm gonna turn this on for a second. That's gonna kill, yeah. It's just so I can take a better picture. Don't mind me. So I make these photos available on the gallery's Patreon website, so you can take a look at the whole process. I've got the whole process for the whole painting. All right, getting close. Sometimes these paintings are just like grueling. It's like, wow, this is challenging. Just hard on your brain. So much going on in the brain.
Oh yeah, I love all those layers and layers of transparent paint and texture coming up. I love it.
It's taken me a long time to figure out how to paint like this. Just doing my own thing, figuring that shit out for a long time. Alright, let's see. Let's do some scaly scales. Do a super tiny sharp brush. What do I got that fits that description? This one of my work. I don't need a ton of, I don't need all the scales. Just some in the right place will give this great shimmery quality to it. A little more red there.
can just cleave through some of the shines I've already done. That will make scales appear out of nowhere. Insta-scale. Somehow my exposure is way too light now and it's making my frame rate weird. Let me check it out. What happened there? That's better. Shit, what brush was I using? I think this one? I don't remember. Damn it. I think this sharper one. Let's make some of these a little yellower pointing upward.
Ooh, well, that's some slow, painstaking work there. And if I don't like it, I can dull it down a little bit. Let's see what that looks like in the mirror. Looks pretty cool. Oh yeah, I wanted to add some details to the wings too. Let me pull up something real quick. Let's do some details up here. I think I'm gonna have to stand for this part. Well, actually, if I'm gonna stand, let's do that last. I have one more bit to do over here. I'm gonna do. Ooh. Gonna do a sword and a shield over here, as if she's laid them down. Hence the name Disarming. They're both putting down their weapons. I might be totally like right in the way of the camera, but oh well. I gotta get in here. That one. Maybe the big ones I won't need. This is a job for tiny brushes. This pile of purple because I don't need it and it's just in my way. Don't want that consistency of paint right here. Let's make that a little more angled. And a straight line would be nice. Careful there, stick.
Let's make a nice red hilt ruby or something. Like she's set down her weapons
and they're gonna hug it out.
This was my purple one, doesn't it? Maybe I did need that purple after all.
I forgot to do a little bit back here. Now I should do a little bit of light value on the top plane of this rock that she's standing on. Because
this will let me do that as well. Where did I get this color from? Do a little cast shadow. That needs to go up a little bit. There we go. I do need to just fill this in. Nice, there's a little shadow there now. Technically, that should be out just a little bit then. Angle that a little better. There we go. I can throw a shadow underneath that. That's better. Let's go a little lighter on that, the edge of this cliff there. Those little value changes are kind of important, really important. Oh, that helped a lot, actually. Ooh, yeah, that's great. Sword and shield discarded. Maybe they're a little big for her, but she's a freaking badass. She can wield that shit.
what's left. Some wing detail. Oh, and there's going to be a little bird up there. A hawk. Just for fun. Stand up for this. Which means I want to raise this up. I'll raise that up. Sorry, it's really tough to adjust this thing without it looking crazy. Oh, it's way too dark now. That's fine. Kind of set up my easel so I could stand here a little bit. This be like, thanks, guys.